Hello. I'm going to rave about you for a second. Animated is just a beautiful show, first off. The feel is extremely consistent. It's reliable, but it's not predictable. The characters complement each other really well. They each have their own individual thing, yet they all work together as a team. They mesh beautifully. What I'm curious about is, did you use some sort of formula to create that perfect team, so to speak, or did they all just sort of culminate together to create this thing?
Well, if you're starting with the Autobot team, you want contrasting and complementing characters that each bring their own strengths and flaws and will be, you know, an interesting combination. It evolved. It didn't start. If you've seen Jim's book, you'll see there was an evolution to it where Ratchet was originally Red Alert, and Red Alert was female. Bumblebee was originally Hotshot, and then that changed. So a lot of things changed and evolved as we went through them. A lot of it had to do with the voice casting. And the voice actors brought certain things to the characters. Tremendous amount of it had to do with the design, where I might have had a certain idea for a character, and then I saw Derek's design, I said, oh, now I understand who this character is. We need to lean into that. Prowl was kind of ill-defined early on, and he was more of kind of a dark rebel, almost a Wolverine loner kind of guy, and it wasn't quite playing. And it was literally somebody, one of the freelancers, Mike Ryan. There was a scene where Prowl's looking at a nature documentary, and he just said, "Fascinating," just in the same way that Spock would have said it. And I said, "Oh, okay, there's a direction for him." So we kind of went more into the nature boy than the rebel, but we still, we paid tribute to the rebel because that's kind of how we played him in the pilot, and then we saw that there was an evolution. We went back to his backstory, and we saw that there was an evolution to that personality. So it all kind of grew organically, to use a very non-Transformer word, and it was the result of 3 years of lunches and conversations, largely between me and Matt and Derek and a lot of the directors and designers.
Awesome, thank you.
Yeah, and to add a little bit more to that answer too, before we actually greenlit the cartoon at Hasbro, like I was in developing the Classics line at the time, and my boss Aaron Archer asked me to we want to do a new cartoon. We need you to start devoting some time to present stuff internally. And similar to what Marty was saying, it's like even prior to his early generations and evolutions of the characters and the team and stuff like that, we were doing the same thing on our side at Hasbro at the time. And the original team that I had was going to be Optimus Prime, it was going to be Hotshot, Grimlock, Jetfire, and then I think I was going back and forth between a female version of Prowl and or a female Junkion. So we had played with a lot of different dynamics. I wasn't kind of thinking about the character dynamics as they play out on the show. I was thinking about what's a cool, broad, wide look at how different these toys can look from each other, So it's kind of interesting how a writer versus a toy designer would look at a line. It's like, oh. Yeah.
Well, I think there was also a big influence from the Cartoon Network side of things because Sam Register and Tram Wigzell were really trying to make this feel like a Cartoon Network show. And so they'd had a lot of success with Ben 10, so they were looking for that comedic angle and that sort of superhero angle as opposed to, the robots at war angle. So I think a lot of that influenced where we went with what those personalities and what that team would be.
Family-esque type feel.
Yeah. I will cop to being very influenced by the team dynamic on Gargoyles, which I wrote on, and you can sort of see the pairing. Yeah. I think some fans have pointed that out, and they are correct. It's 10 years later, so I can admit to all the things I stole.
And I remember in conversations with Sam and Derek both, they both drew a lot of inspiration from the Mighty Orbots.
Yeah, visually, yeah. For sure. I mean, that you saw, anybody who saw the opening, the main title, and recognized it right away. I mean, just cribbing things directly from that.
So that's that touch point is actually very interesting too. It's like up to that point, you know, we were coming off the Armada, Energon, Cybertron, the Unicron trilogy, and it was just basically a very long, drawn out, like, you know, here's what's happening, everybody's battling, but it didn't really delve into the character story as much as we would have liked. And what we discovered during the process of Animated is, like, you can completely change this story and make it a lot more personal, a lot more family-oriented, and a lot more interesting, even with a smaller cast of characters that allows you, you know, to be able to explore those relationships and stuff. So that was, like, a huge, huge learning thing for us at the time.
Yeah, I think it really worked to just start with these five characters and then build out the universe from them, rather than start with this enormous universe and figure out what corner of it these five characters belong.
Yeah.
So that we had a lot of freedom on that because we weren't beholden to the continuity, any previous continuity.
Mm-hmm. That is something I think a lot of people appreciated about this particular series, is it's so unique, but it's still consistent, it still fits, and the characters are still really powerful and touching. So thank you guys.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.